evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the April 27, 2016 Select Board meeting. I'll call this meeting to order. First order of business is that we didn't say that Mr. Pipkinsey was our new Select Board member that was elected at our spring town meeting, and of course John was re-elected also, so we welcome them to the board. We also have our consent agenda this evening, and we have warrants AP 1644 and AP 1644S.
Motion approved.
There a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you. And for the rest of the consent agenda, we have permission to use the reservoir April 30th for a fishing derby, and a one-day malt and wine liquor license approval of use on the West Street Common for June 4th, which is the Asparagus Festival. Motion?
Motion to accept.
Question?
First. Second.
Second. I'll second it for discussion.
Open to discussion. Yes. Who wants to, you
want
to go first?
Don seconded it. Yep.
You want to do discussion?
Yes.
Go ahead.
It's the same Young Men's Club putting this on again, like they do every year. Mm-hmm. And I'd like to commend them for the efforts they do for the children of this town. It's a great fundraiser, and the kids really enjoy it.
Anybody else? No? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. And then we are now open for public comments. Anybody have anything to say this evening? John?
I could ask, there's three selectmen's meeting in a row that I attend and I ask questions. What's the sense of asking a question when there's never an answer? It's just a waste of time.
It depends.
I know in a planning board, the first half hour we open it for the general public to ask questions, if you know, if they have anything about zoning and permits and all that. And it works well, explaining the bylaws, explaining different things. But here you come in, you ask a question, and it don't go nowhere. There's never an answer to it. So what's the purpose of answering questions?
If it has to go into any great detail, 15 minutes is not a lot of time to answer somebody's questions. But we're feeling that if we can answer something quickly within the first 15 minutes, then we will. We're reviewing that process right now, but I think that that might change in the future, that we will be able to answer some questions
again,
in that short period of time.
I'm asking that task force why I was not, or why I couldn't serve on it.
Which task force?
On that medical marijuana.
Because it's not a task force.
Well, we'll call it what
it's a negotiating team, and you are not on the Board of Selectmen. So that's one of the reasons that you're not.
So everybody on that thing is part of the Board of Selectmen?
Correct.
The police chief was not on there, and nobody?
He has to do with what's happening with that.
Well, so don't we as a planning board.
No, you don't.
Yes, we do.
You do not in the negotiation process.
No, I'm not negotiating that just to find out about the information.
Well, we can pass on that information when it becomes made available, but it's not available at this point.
Maui Keegan told me I'm in conflict of interest. That's absolute bull. I don't own nothing there. I have no relatives there. And I asked her to put it in writing so I could pass it on to the State Ethics Commission, because it doesn't cost nothing for me to call them and ask their opinion if, in fact, it is a conflict. And I know it isn't.
Well, then let us ask Molly what she meant by that. She's not here this evening, so we will bring that.
Well, she just asked.
I know, but I will make her, have her clarify that with you on what you're
in conflict
of.
I'm going to call the Ethics Commission anyway, so
okay.
That's okay. Because they got no satisfaction from you folks at Selectmen.
Okay, so what else?
Secondly, I asked about the bridge. What's going on with the bridge? Everybody sat there. So the next day, I went down to district headquarters, and I asked them, the bridge engineer, the traffic engineer, and they told me exactly. Mr. Nixon was there when they held the hearing. He just sat there and never said a word. And people were asking, I heard all kinds of rumors, this happened, this, so I wanted to find out exactly. And you guys sitting there knew it. He knew it. He was there.
It's a state project.
No. But the people, they gotta understand why the road is blocked, why the lights are up there, and there's no construction, and why the barriers are there.
I believe that we did clarify that in one of our meetings on why that was happening.
Then why is there so many people, including myself, that didn't know what was actually happening there?
You must have missed our meeting.
Well, I really don't want to meet.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
Just want to remind everybody that we had a information session about the Bay Road Bridge project on February 24th, 2016.
Where?
Here. This is on the agenda for February 24th.
Our meeting.
The Select Board talked about it.
Would you mind explaining, Mr. Nixon, seeing you were there?
We were all here. That was our meeting, John, that night.
And it was quite confusing at the beginning, John, because when they first put the Jersey barriers up and loaded that bridge with about 40,000 pounds, I had a lot of questions. And David sent emails to the state engineer originally, and we didn't get a response back right away. When did we get the response back?
Took about a week.
So, and then in the meantime, I wasn't paying attention to my emails, and David sent it to me. And then I read the information and kept it amongst myself, okay? But it was available to the whole board. The whole board knew what was going on with these updates.
But
we didn't let the public know at that time what was going on.
But the thing, John, I asked that specific question, and if you knew, again, I found out because the poles were rotted, so they shifted the weight to the north side of the bridge. Okay, I worked on that bridge 30 years ago when they encased the pillars there with concrete. I made all the forms for that. So then what they explained to me, the pillars were rotten like about this big.
What's the warranty on that?
So what?
What was your warranty on that?
What's your warranty? When you walk out the door? But these were rotted like this, so they had to shift the weight to the north side. And why they put the barriers on there and had to go over there? Because they couldn't put that weight in one spot. They had it transferred the weight throughout the whole bridge.
Yeah.
And if that didn't work, they would close that bridge down. And I could understand that. But that's what I asked, and you guys, he was there. He should have answered that.
Okay, do you have anything else?
Do I have anything else?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I was at the Historic Commission yesterday, and they voted to support the plan I had on using the
Who's this?
The Historic Commission yesterday. They're going to send you a letter. And they were not happy that they weren't invited to the meeting to deal with the North Hadley Hall. They have a big interest in. I suggest that you at least invite them in.
Excuse me. We have a building committee. You have been in contact, David, am I correct, with the Historical Commission?
So they have been
in the process right from the get-go, is that not true?
Yes, and I believe the Select Board did invite them to participate in the sale of the North Hadley Village Hall RFP selection process. So if they were not part of that process, it wasn't intentional. They were invited.
There was Historical Commission members of the bid opening as well, and they were also invited, I believe, to the public forum that was held about a year and a half ago of the North Hadley Hall.
Yeah, they said about that when you discussed it here at your last selectman's meeting.
Well, they were part of the committee that was authorized to go ahead with the RFP, correct?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And they were part of that process, so I'm not sure which piece they're missing or. I'm not sure.
I just hope you don't take no action on that at this time.
Well, okay. That's for us to decide.
Can I make a comment about the bridge? I was in attendance at that meeting with Mr. Nixon. Mr. Nixon asked numerous questions. I asked numerous questions. DPW didn't even have the answers for us. It was happening so fast. Oh, we got to check with other engineers on that. We have to do this. We have to call Boston. And we couldn't get the answers from them that day. And then a lot of things got clarified a week later. And setting up the bridge. I even asked, is it possible to get some funding to put an alternate bridge in there the way they did in the Oxbow, if you remember how they come in and put a bridge. And that's something they're gonna look into. We don't know if we have the money to finance that or not, but the pending bridge.
It's not us, so let's clarify that.
No, it is, it's a state project, this is what they were referring to. And they don't even plan on starting any work over there, probably for a year, right? The way they were.
June, low water, June.
And stuff, so, you know, but they're looking at other alternatives to lessen the burden on the traffic in that area. You know, and the highway department was there representing us, the police department was there representing us, the school department was there, so everybody was there asking the questions, how can we alleviate this problem, so.
The biggest concern that most of the board had at the time, John, through all this confusion, was the emergency services. The police cruisers, the fire trucks, the ambulances, and that's why I had a lot of questions about the loading of the bridge, dead loading and shock loading and everything else. He was pretty in-depth when he came back, the Jersey barriers weigh, the concrete ones weigh about 40,000 pounds. Water barriers are a couple, 280 pounds, I believe, less. And I had asked them if they would just put up plastic barriers, but there was no response back for that, actually, in that letter.
No.
So.
Okay, does anyone else have any other questions this evening?
It's for John.
John didn't sign.
John did.
Yeah.
You signed the letter?
Yeah. I think that's all I can say.
I don't know if this could fall under public comment. We were all emailed by our present chairman, she's away on family matters and stuff, but she suggested to us to change the format of the public meeting, period. And I agree with her wholeheartedly, and I don't know about you people, but I would entertain a motion for discussion of that.
I think that's scheduled, I think, for next Wednesday's meeting.
Oh, it is? I didn't see it on the agenda.
The agenda hasn't come out because I asked.
But they're gonna do that for next Wednesday.
Yes, sir.
That's fine, and she'll be back to defend it.
Yep.
Which is good, thank you.
If it's constructive criticism, then we should be able to discuss it in this public meeting section. If it's really something that needs to be researched and you need an answer to it, then it's gotta go further than 15 minutes before the meeting, I feel. But I think it's a good idea to address some of these issues now.
I agree with you, Mr. Washkevich, but it's gonna take more than a half an hour for constructive criticism. Might be for a day or two.
Well, that's everybody's opinion.
Well, there's a lot of knowledge on this board, many, many years, and most of these select persons have been through this and answered these questions numerous times, along with our administrator. So if it's an emergency, it's something we probably could direct them like we do and deal with it very quickly. If it's something very serious, I think we've got to have like a 48-hour getting back to these people so they don't have to come to the board, then go on Friday to be put on the agenda, and then come back the following week to be heard. I think we can expedite that somehow.
I think she's going to talk about that next Wednesday.
I agree. Thank you.
All right, so let's move on at 7:15. I'm going to go out of order here and go to the Hadley Flea Market update. Our chief had a busy night, and I'm sure the Jalas would like to get done with their business tonight also. Could you...
Mr. Jala is prepared.
Mr. Jala, are you...
Prepared to talk about...
Prepared to talk about right now?
No.
No?
Right now.
Mr. Chief Mason, would you like to share us on the update of your...
Certainly. I know the first Sunday of the flea market was a mess. We take partial responsibility for that. We just weren't prepared for the amount of traffic that was going to be there with only two officers to direct traffic. I don't think Ray had any idea that many people were going to show up. I know that this has been an issue in the past, and a lot of people are, upset about the traffic on Sundays, but in Mr. Shaw's defense, he had a bit of a perfect storm going on, with it being a three-day weekend, nice weather. First flea market of the season is always the worst, so plus the bridge didn't help. We had a meeting with Mr. Shaw the following week after the flea market to try to set up a game plan for this past Sunday. Sergeant Cook put together a plan that really worked and turned it around almost 100%. We went from 30 or 40 complaints, calls for complaint, to one that we know of. They were able to actually keep traffic off the bridge this past Sunday. We added some extra officers to direct traffic, assuming that we would have to be dealing with what was occurring on the bridge, but we worked with Ray's parking people. We used our road sign, our signboard to help direct traffic. We had an officer moving up and down the roadway to make sure that the people that were parking on private property the week before, we didn't have any more of those problems as well. So normally, you know, the first few flea markets are always like this. They're always pretty bad. And we have Mother's Day weekend coming up and a graduation as well. Those are usually two of the pretty tough weekends to deal with. Mr. Shala is working with us. We have a plan in place that we're going to continue to work with and do the best we can with it. We have, like I said, we have a couple of busy weekends coming up, but we're confident that we can do the same thing these upcoming weekends that we did this past weekend. Unfortunately, we did have to add, you know, a couple of officers to deal with the road problems. But that will taper off as flea market traffic tapers off as well. There's some changes that you could possibly make inside that I think Sergeant Cook actually addressed a couple of them with Mr. Shala and his family this past Sunday. They were very open to making those changes and actually did them immediately and seemed to help significantly. There's probably a few more things we could do. But we'll work with them on dealing with those issues.
Mm-hmm. Do you have anything at this point, Mr. Jala or Linda, that wanted to speak about this at all?
Not yet.
Not yet. Are you more positive after how the weekend went this weekend?
Well, it was better. It was much better.
Much better, okay.
We're directed the traffic on the 3 acres, mm-hmm. but Mike Cook figured we should. We tried. Mm-hmm. Maybe it helped.
Okay. As long as everybody's content at this point, that's a good thing. And everybody working together, so that helps.
To work. I don't know.
Okay.
Can I make a comment?
Sure.
I was out of the country and I came back and I had numerous calls on my answering machine about the flea market. So this Sunday, I woke up before 5 o'clock, went there. There was already numerous amount of vendors, and they park where the public should be parking. And I come back at 12, there was no problem with traffic. I came back at 2 when they're starting to close down. I spoke to Mr. Shala in length, and we discussed that, and he's already implemented. He's very complimentary on any suggestions trying to eradicate the problem, and I compliment them on that for being so directive and trying to eliminate it. I don't feel it's his responsibility to assume the problems that the bridge causes. That's a state project and a town project, and he shouldn't assume the liability for the bridge. You know, it's not his fault. There's nothing he can do about that, but
we're not saying that. I think that it was the problem of the amount of traffic that was going to the flea market at the time to alleviate that problem. It just wasn't the bridge traffic that was causing the congestion. It was
a lot
of different things. We've all been up there.
The first day I went up,
I think we've all
went
been up there,
there about
right?
9:30. I spoke
You've
to Mr.
There.
Cook.
You lived there.
And I went up. It took me about 10 minutes to get from the bridge up to flea market.
Mm-hmm.
I came back down, and the cars going south were actually parked on the bridge because the traffic had already backed up to the bridge at that point. Well, in the meantime, at the corner of Bay Road and Lawrence Plain, I see the Rock and Mineral Show signs. And I went over to the Village Barn, and there was somewhere between 100 and 150 cars there. So that also didn't help the traffic situation on the bridge or the flea market on the first day. So I think it was a little bit of everything that just congested the whole area.
It was a lot of different things that really kind of affected that first weekend, so.
But I think everybody has to take into effect that Sergeant Cook has done well and works with this, and he's the one that's been doing this project and trying to work with you and make sure things are good. And I have to commend him for his positive outlook and enthusiasm that he keeps.
Like I said, this past weekend, we were able to keep the traffic off the bridge. So the extra officers actually did their job. They kept the traffic from flowing. The problem, the bridge problem, was not the problem.
I think a lot of people went Bay Road after they came down. Instead of going the bridge, they headed out the other way, which by my house.
Unfortunately, until we ask DOT to put a counter or something down there, we're never going to know why people are down there, where they're going, where the traffic is from. It's just difficult. All I know is that, you know, on Sundays during the flea market, the traffic doesn't look like that the other 6 days of the week. So we had to do something to fix it.
I have one more question for the chief concerning this situation.
Sure.
I see the new signage for the trucks. Has that eliminated trailer trucks going over there?
No.
More or less, it's still happening?
It's happening.
A lot?
The reports that we get when they do what they call spot checks on the bridge, not as much, the numbers aren't as high, but they reached out to Sergeant Cook the other day, and they're actually considering offering paid details to our department as well as state police to post there and write tickets. I don't know if they actually officially requested yet, but they've kind of opened the discussions for that.
It'd be great if they, Andy?
Is there a thought of putting a camera out there for, you know, because that's a,
yeah,
you know, they have an expensive way that they would review that. And
that would be DOT that would do that.
Yeah.
Right.
John?
Well, just speaking about that, the other day I was going home from the shop, there was a big bus that flew through there. But talking about now going back to the traffic jam, it's no different than the traffic jam right here on Route 9, double lanes, way to the bridge, all the way to Spruce Hill. Mm-hmm. What are we going to do about that?
Well, it's going to be worse now with the
Coming. And you can't stop people. And Sunday, people want to go traveling and stuff. And that's not all his fault. He got no control of sightseers or what, you know?
Nope.
But we got this. We get a bigger jam right here in the center of town on Route 9, from the bridge all the way to Spruce Hill. And I've been caught enough things in that. And nobody's doing nothing about that.
It's going to be worse this coming week.
Right. Chief. Nothing's going to get better.
Have you or Mitch ever thought about getting a counter? Another department have one we could borrow and see how many cars go in and out of that place on a particular weekend?
I don't know
the
police department that has one, but Mitch actually was going to reach out to DOT to try to pull one.
Yeah, see if they got one maybe. And then you'll have a number to look at anyway.
Yeah, I mean, what may end up resulting, I mean, we were just bantering back and forth, but we were talking about what that could result in. And what it could result in is, depending on the traffic numbers that come in, maybe that pushes DOT to widen the road, add another lane, something like that. I don't know. I mean, the amount of traffic that comes in there, like John said, you don't know. We don't know where it's going. We don't know if it's people going south, people going north, people going to the flea market. Whatever it is, wherever they're going, it's too much for that little road. Mm-hmm. Well, at least it was the first Sunday. I mean, we're figuring out.
Well, if it's a state road and they reconstruct it, they'll put a bike lane in. Will you park the cars on the bike lane?
They'll probably put four of them in the sidewalk.
Okay, so we'll move right along now. I guess thank you very much, Chief, for your anything else from you tonight?
I don't know. If you need me for something else.
I don't think we need you here for anything else.
Right.
Unless you wanted to share anything tonight. You're all done?
I'm good.
Okay.
Protect and serve.
I think the chief did a good job.
He always does a good job.
Yeah.
We're still in new business.
Did you get that on tape?
No, I'm going
to. I'm going to play that one again.
That was a painful one.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Madam Chair, one more question when it comes regarding to all this traffic discussion is the UMass, becoming UMass graduation with the Mass DOT.
A6.
Starting on the 2nd, I'm sure there hasn't been any discussion to say hold off 4 days.
Why, I, what are you gonna do with it?
Where the hell's your phone?
There has been a discussion.
Actually, they're not gonna be bothering our Memorial Day parade, they said that should go through.
We have information on the Route 9 update that may be helpful to that, correct?
Yeah.
Well, let's see.
You wanna talk about the, with the Finance Committee?
Why don't we do, that'll just take us a few minutes, and then we'll get to the Route 9. Let's do, we're late with the, we have an appointment with the Finance Committee right now. Mark and Amy are here.
Yeah.
Do you wanna go over just quickly how things turned out on Saturday? And anything added you wanna say about the warrant and the budget tonight?
Did, one department in particular come back and asked more or less where they were in the pecking order on, you know, come fall town meeting. And we had John help to entertain us with some lively discussion.
Excuse me?
We have lively discussion? Yeah.
Okay.
The other issues are that we've gotten as balanced a budget as we think we can. You'll notice a lot of the, some of the items have been pushed into the fall to try and kick the can a little bit down the road, but we wanna be sure when we get the certified free cash in order to pay for them. So that's why we're waiting till after fall town meeting to disperse that money.
As we have done in the past.
Yes, and we have in the past, this is not, nothing new.
And part of the final decision is we are putting OPEB to the fall?
Yes.
Okay. So you just balance it the best we can?
That's it.
So we're gonna get together and make sure that our numbers are reconciled.
Correct.
And then we'll produce the final budget at that point for everybody. The warrant has been posted on the website at www.hadleyma.org. I also have copies here if anybody wants a physical copy right now. We also have to assign the motions, and we also have to decide if we're gonna do a consent agenda. I'll give you the real one.
Is the moderator in favor of the consent agenda?
Thank you. Yes, he is.
Do we need to do that now?
You wanna do that next Wednesday?
For next Wednesday?
I'd like to produce the motions for everybody and give the people, well, at least a weekend to go through them. So if we knew whose articles are assigned to whom, then you have a chance to study up for this town meeting.
Okay.
So we can take 5 minutes and go through and figure it out. In your mailbox today, you have this sheet of paper?
Yeah.
So the first three articles are on the consent agenda, but in case they're removed from the consent agenda, does anybody wanna handle them? They're the housekeeping articles.
I'll handle them if they come away from that. So new selectmen, do you have any preference, since you haven't been here for the rest of it? Is there any preference to what you'd like to handle on the listing?
See where it says simple?
Take one of those.
Anything, I don't mind, whatever. I've been through it many times, so it doesn't matter where you wanna put me in. I should be able to talk about it.
Let's go down the list then. Let's do revolving funds. I'll do that.
Both of them?
Sure.
Four and five.
Okay, budget adjustment. Molly?
Yeah.
See what you get when you're not here. Budget retroactive pay for unions. I could do that.
I'll do that, Joyce.
Do I do that? Okay. You split those. HPAT revolving fund?
Don.
I'll do that.
Omnibus budget, that would be the Finance Committee. water filtration stabilization.
Divine.
John?
Oh, I don't care, John, you want to do that?
I don't care.
Capital One borrowing. Is that going to be the capital committee?
No.
No? Capital One and Capital Two?
Yeah, I'll take care of it, yeah.
Want to do both of those?
Yeah.
Maintenance budget adjustment passed over.
Could that be explained? Because I was way out of the country and some of these changes I didn't notice until I looked at it right now.
Okay. We have, the reason why this one was passed over is because we currently have a balance in the former Russell School maintenance account, which can be used for any building now, for about $94,000 and change. And since the request for number 13 was $72,000, and we were already having trouble with the budget, we decided to defer this until the fall town meeting.
Russell School, now that we're going to be renting it to the construction company, is there a firm figure what we'll be receiving monthly from them?
Right, so this is going to come up on your agenda for next week.
Next week,
yes,
fine.
They have a lease agreement that they would like to propose, and that money will be put into a revolving fund for the maintenance and upkeep of that building.
Okay, capital number three.
Me.
Land purchase, Molly.
We speak loud and joyous, I can't hear you.
Land purchase, Molly.
What article?
Number 15. Capital reallocation of funds.
I'll do that one.
Well, how about Donald?
Okay.
Donald?
It's all right, fine with me.
Library is covered, solar pilot.
Madam Chairman, can I ask a question?
Yes.
Why is the library following the last? I should think it should be in front of Article 11, because if it's voted down, then you don't need Article 11. Then Article 15 should be the third one following. So if they vote for this and they don't vote for that, for, you know, for the senior center, Article 15, then Article that.
Well, I think the plan was is that we still need land purchase.
No, but I mean,
so whether or not it goes with the library or not, or if it goes with the senior center, then.
But if that's voted down, then they're not going to knock down the Hooker School. So why would you need that?
The language for senior center under Article 11 is new to me.
That don't make sense to me.
Before it said, you know, municipal buildings. Mm-hmm. So. Adding senior center in there, you know, I agree that would add some confusion to it, but that wasn't the original intent coming out of the building committee. Of course, this number was.
So number 11 wasn't.
It wasn't
senior center
specific. That was part of the concept, but it wasn't specific for it was for future municipal buildings.
So in other words, the OPM should be. Used for any potential new building construction that we perform. That might be a North Hadley fire substation, that might be a senior center, community center, or additions to the existing public safety complex. It was intended to be for any of those purposes for which the select board deems as the priority.
So was that 11 or was that 15?
That was 11.
That was 11.
Madam Chairman, though, if they all got voted down, why would you even?
I want to ask David.
Well, kind of under information, which is you've already signed and posted the warrant. The order of articles are now set. Mr. Michkowski may have an excellent point, but we can't do anything about it.
No, you can move it on the floor.
You can move it on the floor, but we can't do it right now.
Well,
so
no,
we,
just to talk about it, if it makes sense or not.
We could move it, yes.
That's
that would just, somebody would just have to say to move.
Move. Yeah, I got that all written out, but
okay.
I just wanted to see what was.
Okay. So did you, we not?
So we're at number 19 for the solar pilot.
Okay, who's?
Molly.
Molly. I'll do the possession of alcohol.
Quorum, I'll do.
I might possess it. Jerry. Annual town meeting on Saturday bylaw. Who's in favor of that?
John.
Yeah.
John.
I'm the culprit on that one. I'm going to go park on it.
And so concludes.
You own it, so I think, that is all that we have to discuss at this point.
What article was that one?
That was 22. Annual town meeting on Saturday bylaw. Someone had requested that we change the day.
Will of the people.
Will of the people.
Can we also get an explanation for 28, why that's being passed over also?
That would be the planning board.
Well, the planning board, they received comments back from council. The comments were extensive, and they didn't feel that they had enough time to digest this in time for the town meeting, so they decided to defer this until the fall.
27 and 28?
27 is still there. 28 is passed over.
Oh, okay.
4.1, 4.2? That was something you messed up there, Dave, when you rewrote that thing when Jimmy Max faxed you, and I said instead of mending this on the floor, pass it over, because then there's going to be confusion of it. But he explained that he sent you in some kind of different form that you didn't have, and it, when you printed that out, he come out totally wrong. That's what he explained at our planning board meeting.
All right, well, that's
so I asked for him to pass it over so there's no confusion on a town meeting floor, come back in the fall.
That's new information, thank you.
Yep.
Would you classify 27 as the tiny house?
Yes.
29
is zoning 3. It's by petition. Well, it's planning board petitioner.
That wasn't planning board. That was the tiny house.
Tiny house.
Right.
So those are...
Is everybody in agreement on the consent articles? There are five of them. These are the same five as we've done for 2 years running.
Mm-hmm. Housekeeping articles.
Yep.
Anything to move town meeting along?
Yep.
All set with the finance committee then at this point then? Are you all set?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're
going to meet with David and do the numbers.
Yes, who's reading what when
okay.
You're going to sequence it. But we're pretty much squared away. I mean, as squared away as we can be before we find out what free cash is and what our real growth numbers are.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. So we'll do project manager. Project manager, which the building committee is in on that one also, right?
Correct.
So we received seven qualification statements of qualifications. We're going to box those up with the permission of the select board tonight, send them off to the evaluation committee for them to review. Just as a reminder that this is a project that we're going to negotiate the final price, so the evaluation committee will bring back their highest ranked candidates and the select board will enter into negotiations. Is this an acceptable course of action?
It is, and the evaluation team is also on that now. So
yep.
Who's on that committee? Please.
I have Molly Keegan, Andy Klopacki, David Waskevitz, Dan Regish, Linda Ziegenbein.
Okay.
forget anybody?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any further discussion?
Madam Chairman?
Yes?
Could I ask what this is for? What project?
This is for the project manager.
For what? The project?
For any of our projects.
Well, yeah, this was a directive that I believe came from the select board to have an OPM. An OPM, of course, is required for any project over
5 million.
Or 1.5 million.
1.5 million.
$1.5 million, of which there may be some, but I believe the intent was to get from the select board at the time is to get an OPM on board should these other projects move ahead.
No cost at this point in time?
I'm under the impression there is not a specific task yet, so I don't know exactly what project they were. I know that the OPM representatives were toward the buildings and got a look at some of the potential projects, and I'm not sure exactly the dollar figure, whether or not that would be an hourly rate, because there wasn't a definitive.
That's what you'll be evaluating.
Project, yeah.
That'll include any of the projects?
There's a
that are outstanding, including the library?
Library has their own.
The library has their own. This would be the net result of moving ahead with the library. There would have to be, you know, consider one for
okay.
The next step.
Is this going to cost us any money, or are you going to wait for?
Doesn't cost us a dime. We're looking for qualified applicants interested.
That's it?
That's correct.
No contracts will be signed?
Is there a contract? Well, that's to be determined.
Yeah, we would negotiate the final price, whether that be hourly, whether that be lump sum, whether that be project by project. That's all a matter of negotiations. We do have a sum of money on the annual town meeting warrant for owner's project manager. Any one of these building projects is going to trigger this state requirement. This is the first step towards doing something serious about any one of these buildings. The priorities are obviously going to be hammered out with the Municipal Building Committee, with the support of the Select Board. But the owner's project manager is really the first legal step that we have to take.
But if you don't, the town meeting doesn't vote for you, then you don't need this.
You do need this.
For what?
You are required to have an owner's project manager for any municipal building project.
What if the project is not voted? That's what I'm asking.
Well, I think we've been in a 5-year-long conversation about all of our buildings needing work of some kind, and we're not talking about a fresh coat of paint. We're talking about major renovations. We had a facilities report done, the DRA report, which is posted online, by the way. With cost estimates, any one of which building is going to exceed $1.5 million. So if we're really serious about doing something with our buildings, we have to take this next step. This is a requirement of state law.
What's the dollar threshold for that?
$1.5 million.
So they're not at that now, and there's...
That's correct.
They're not at that level. And the building committee didn't get any money to do any. I think they asked for $200,000, and you get them nothing. So what are they going to do with nothing?
Well, those are two different things at that point.
Right. Those are two different things. That's not the same thing. Those are other projects they have on agenda that they. David, do you want?
This is the maintenance.
No, John, this is new construction or serious renovation projects. So should the select board choose to advance any one of our recommendations, North Hadley Fire Substation, Russell School, renovations to the public safety complex, community center, senior center, any of those projects will trigger an OPM.
I know, but
so that's why we need an OPM on board.
Well, why don't we vote for that? You got plenty of time. When you the town meeting, you vote for it, then you vote for that.
Well, there was some speculation that with the timing that should the library get advanced.
Well, I just think you're wasting that time.
Well, there isn't going to be any expenditures unless right. that happens. Unless town meeting votes, you know, approves that. I think this the intent of this coming out of the select board was to be prepared should this actually...
If it's a no cost, I have absolutely no idea about that.
Well,
John...
We could sell that 10 minutes ago.
John, what we're trying to do is actually get ahead of this game here right now. We've been falling behind in some of our actions in the past, and this step is to move forward with some of the projects that the building committee has recommended to us.
But so, I also know, John, that this town spent thousands of dollars on studies and never did anything with those.
They're all coming together now, John. We're looking at every one of them that we ever had done.
We can't take away from the studies we've already done.
Yes, they're all here. They're all ready.
We're trying to get the money together. I mean, this is part of the thing that's been ongoing with the building committee.
Motion and second on the floor, Madam Chair.
Motion and second are on the floor. Vote, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Project manager on board.
This is actually the same scenario that the school had to do with their renovation project, and they had to hire a project manager to get that done. It's the same exact thing.
Okay, so old business again, real estate purchase request for proposals. We opened the proposals last week.
So we have two proposals submitted, one for a parcel of land in the center of town, another one for a parcel of land in the north end of town. The information has been transmitted to the evaluation team. I'd like the board's endorsement to do that. And this is on your agenda for the fourth for them to come back with a ranking, and at that time we'll open up the price proposals.
So moved.
Can I ask what part?
Well, just a minute. Is there a second?
Second.
So there are two parcels of land, correct?
Two proposals.
And these will be going to the evaluation team, as we spoke of before.
Yep.
Can I ask what partials?
Parcel in the center of town. I don't happen to have an ID for it. Parcel at the north end of town.
What is it?
I'm telling you, that's as much information as I have in front of me right now.
So there's two pieces of property that will be going to this evaluation team.
Ask a question.
That actually fell into a category of, what was it, 8 or 10 acres or more?
Correct.
No, 4.4.
4.4.
Oh, more than three.
More than three.
Mr. David. Nixon, if I could just get some clarification, I think it was the Municipal Buildings Committee understanding that there was an RFP issued for property in North Hadley to address a need for a North Hadley fire substation, yet separately there was an RFP issued for property in the center of town. Was that actually not the case, or were there actually two RFPs that were issued?
There was an RFP that looked for a property preferably in the center of town. There were two proposals that were that came back. One was for a parcel in the center of town. The other one is a parcel up in North Hadley.
Okay. So the other parcel that was defined as north of Huntington for the potential purchase of a property for the North Hadley, potential North Hadley substation.
Yeah.
That,
so I mean, it's up to the evaluation committee to determine whether both or either of these proposals are responsive to what we were looking for. Bring that information back to the select board. We'll open up the prices and we'll see where we are at that point.
Okay, thank you.
Right. Madam Chair, just a little clarification. The select board voted on this a long time ago before I was even on the board, and it differs greatly from what the finance committee rejected both proposals unanimously 5-0. And it's a split vote from the Board of Selectmen. I would almost like to see the Board of Selectmen review their vote again and see how everybody sits on this once again before town meeting.
Would you like to do that at your meeting of the 4th when you open up your price proposals?
I don't want to stop it from going to the evaluation committee. We're going to need it back. Let it go to the evaluation committee so that it gets evaluated. If we want to do that on the 4th, the meeting on the 4th, then Donald can certainly bring that up as a point of order.
Okay.
That's fine.
It should go to the committee first.
And get their recommendation.
Correct.
That would be fine with me.
All those in favor of the motion on the floor?
Aye.
Aye.
So, Madam Chairman, the two parcels are the land for the fire department and the land for the library?
Have not been determined what the parcels are for.
There's just been two parcels that are being looked at to determine what their needs or use could be. And so they'll, it will go to the evaluation team and they will bring back their recommendations.
Are we in a real estate business or is this for a specific use?
It is going to be possibly for specific use. It will be up to the evaluation team to bring that recommendation back to us on what use it could be used for.
We should go in a real estate business.
Well, we are basically. We have a lot of property to deal with. All right, so North Hadley Village Hall proposals for sale of surplus real estate. We opened the bids last week and we had two proposals, one from a Mr. Greenbaum and one from the North Hadley Congregational Church. After a vote was taken last week, we agreed to accept, take under consideration the two proposals. And
since we don't have a full board today, I'd like that put on until next Wednesday as well.
Okay. Is there
a, that's a motion.
Is there a second?
I'll second that motion.
Okay, so that will be put on the agenda for next week on what to do with the North Hadley Hall.
Madam Chairman, is that where you expect to make your decision?
Yes.
Are you going to invite the Historic Commission here to that so they know about it?
They're open for it. They were supposed to be at the bid opening.
They were at the bid opening, John.
Yes.
Yeah, but I know, but this is continued. Will they be notified for that continuance?
We can. Hopefully
certainly.
They're watching TV too.
Well, maybe they won't watch it. They'll miss the show.
Socks
looks always well. From the camera's rolling.
Not everybody watches the show.
Right. Oh, more than
so
you expect,
be
John.
Put on the agenda for next week. Good. Route 9 widening project update. Marlo?
Hello.
Hi. So Route 9
for those widening. That don't know, Marlo Warner is our DPW director.
On April 19th, Mr. Nixon, myself, Mr. Klimowski, both chiefs, excuse me, attended a meeting at MassDOT pre-construction meeting for the project that will be ongoing out here. The slight curveball in the project or the change is a couple of changes. One change is that the gas company has decided they're going to replace their whole main and all the services rather than parts of it. So how that affects us is the water line part of it and the widening, the major part of the widening will not take place until the gas company gets ahead of them. The gas company predicted about 40 days to do their work. So that has now pushed the major part of the road reconstruction out front here out about 40 days, 30 to 40 days.
Really?
Yes.
So not until July?
No, actually.
June?
June, yeah, somewhere in the first week of June.
For us who can't put our hands around that, and it's be very important for everybody around here, does that mean there'll be no digging? What does that actually mean?
I had actually late day news today that some of the changes. The contractor is going to jump around a little bit, but with that being said, they're going to be working off the shoulders, doing some of the widening, possibly some of the water work while the gas company is doing their thing on the north side. So the major part of the reconstruction of the road as far as full depth and whatnot is not going to happen until later in the month or early next month is how I understand it. But I'm going to try and keep in touch with ETNL almost daily, check in with them to make sure that we're on that schedule. The other part of the project that changed was it was supposed to be a 3 or 4 month project. That was only for the route widening. MassDOT ended up reviewing their studies once again and now it's a full reconstruction of the road. So again, that affected the different tabulations that the town was supposed to fund for the project. It actually benefited the town.
part of the roads, where is the widening happening from and to?
Right about Wally Street to 400 feet past Town Hall here. And I believe the widening itself is going to be on the north side. So the latest is we had five historical buildings in the stretch, the scope of work they're doing. They came and did inspections last week, did all five buildings. The five buildings were Russell School, Town Hall, Superintendent's Office, Library, and the Fire Museum. They took pictures, evaluated the buildings before the construction starts, and obviously we'll do another evaluation at the end. Both chiefs were there. They had some concerns on when the reconstruction was going on with the roadway out here, that sometimes there's different layers. Part of the road, one or two lanes will be left 2 feet higher than the other part while they're doing the reconstruction. This is all going to remain one level so that if there's any emergency response, vehicles, ambulances and whatnot that need to get through, they're going to be able to get through as normally as possible. They don't expect a lot of delays. They don't expect a lot of detours, because I had the Bay Road Bridge on my mind, too. If they start detouring traffic around, that could inflame that issue even a little further. So as of right now, they don't plan on shutting the road down at all. It might be minor delays, you know, when they shift from one lane to another while they're installing pipes and whatnot. As far as Mr. Nixon and I, or Mr. Nixon had pointed out that we have numerous events coming up. I think the change in the major part of the construction, it is not going to impact those things as they assured us it wasn't going to be a large impact, because on the weekends they were going to have everything, business as usual, in gravel road, but everything was going to be set. Everybody could pass through, there'd be no, you know, lanes missing or anything like that. So everything being pushed out, I think what you're going to have is like a normal construction gas company crew out here on the edges with police detail. I'm sure it's going to slow traffic down a little bit, but it's not going to be as if the whole road was torn up at once out here.
UMass graduation is May 6th?
7th.
Right. So the other thing they had mentioned at the meeting is the Verizon strike, and that there's some Verizon work I think that needs to be done. So that also is going to have an effect on the project, not on us essentially, but they just don't know how that's going to extend the project out or not, or how that's going to roll in with the gas work and our work.
So the time frame for this entire project, it being pushed back, when do they anticipate being done?
They're still saying 9/11/2017. It went from a 3 or 4 month project to a full year because of the full reconstruction.
They use 9/11 as a date?
Yes, I caught that in the report. I think that's about it. And the gas company does plan on starting somewhere around the 16th. So like I said, there's an overlap. ET&L is still going to do some work with them working at the same time.
16th of May?
Yes.
Andy?
So there's typically a moratorium, 5-year moratorium that you can't make the payment afterwards, after construction. And they're coming a little bit down Middle Street as well.
Yes.
This project. So will there be, you know, will you be taking advantage of this thing being ripped up to update some of our infrastructure, the town-owned infrastructure, like sewer lines or the like?
We are doing water lines.
Actually, the one water line that comes into effect in the intersection out here, I have a small plan that I need to talk to the contractor about. There's an old 8-inch cast iron line that runs the middle of the road through the intersection. With some help with some plans we had at the yard and Dennis Popinski, he come up with some old sheets, and we actually have a 12-inch main that runs through, I guess you call it the side yard here, straight across the library front yard. Mm-hmm. So we're going to attempt to take all the infrastructure out of the intersection out here and tap into that 12-inch. So the answer to your question is yes, we're going to move some things, but not replace out here. We're going to actually abandon the line out here. So same thing. I mean, we're going to tap into the newer line so that we can pull the gates and gate valves and infrastructure out of the middle of the intersection.
Wasn't there one that runs near Russell School that runs underneath to the Donut Man and the wastewater line?
Yeah, that goes inside the Hooker School.
The sewer line we TV'd from the side of the Donut Man, the driveway, all the way through as far as we could get. We didn't clean it and TV throughout the whole line, but we did that section of maybe, I don't know, 500-600 feet, and it looked in fairly decent shape. At some point it may have to be sleeve lined, but not in the immediate future, so it really doesn't have to be replaced at this point.
When was that camera, John?
I can't give you the date right now, John.
Is that the one
we got it back? I think we got it back at the plant.
Is that the
you
one
got
we
them
did?
There, Merle?
Yeah, I think it was one of the newer dates.
Yeah, it was one of the later dates.
Yeah.
Was that the one we did?
No, I don't believe so.
You did a newer one?
Yeah.
Did you compare it to one that we did?
That's a good question. Jesus.
Does that will tell you your true story of deterioration?
When this whole project came down, we TV'd the line all the way across as far as we could get from East Street where we finished off. We TV'd some of the line towards Legion. Then we got stuck in the grit in the
We came all the way down here.
All right, and then from the Donut Man driveway, we went south. We couldn't make it all the way to the pump station because there was just too much grit in the line. So it really needs to be flushed, cleaned, and then re-TV'd. To really know what we have and what condition the inside of that pipe is in.
David, you had a question?
Well, I just had one question, a follow-up on the expanded construction schedule and the full-depth reconstruction. Is there any effect to the sidewalks, particularly from the high school towards Cumberland Farms or towards the intersection? Those are heavily traveled, during school hours, I recognize.
I would say on the north side, yes. If they're widening, you're going to have equipment to the edge of the road and up on the edge of the road. I can reach out to the contractor and pass that.
But north side being towards the Donut Man?
The Donut Man side.
That side?
Yes.
So the sidewalk on this side is not going to be touched? Or is it?
I think they're replacing curbing, so they may have to, do temporary walk behind the walk if there's room or something, but I can reach out to the contractor as we go. I mean, like I said, I'm going to be in touch every day, every other day with them.
Yeah, it'll be about a month, actually, from the start of the project.
Yeah, I just recommend that MassDOT maintains the sidewalks to the best of their ability if there's a construction going on. That's a safety issue. Yeah.
Thank you.
We talked about taking the water that's generated on the roof of this building and filtering it out through a storm drain. We talked about that regarding the problem with the water that's in the driveway. Well, have you had any luck talking to them regarding that issue?
Yes, after the pre-construction meeting, I talked to the GC that's doing a job out here, and I had mentioned to him that there's a drain manhole out here. And while we're at it, it's real close to moving the water line that I had spoke about. If they could just run a stub to the front yard, so to speak, that we can tie into at a later date. He didn't seem to think it'd be a problem at all, and expense would be very minimal.
Excellent.
Okay. Tim?
Madam Chair.
Tim had a question.
The discussion here was that DOT doesn't believe that there's going to be too much of a backup with regard to traffic. We all live here, we realize what actually transpires here. Today, one of the PVTA buses broke down out here. It was sitting here for an hour. That made a backup all the way to the malls. Just a simple thing like that creates such a havoc around here. I think they're kind of unrealistic that we're not going to have backups. I think, is there any push to really say, guys, you need to have a backup scheme on this if we really get to these huge, massive...
We had a lot of conversations with them regarding getting the signs out early enough so that there would be a notification that occurs. The timing, I know they're starting just before the school graduates, but that is factored into it as well to that. And just as the bridge, when we were, everybody was dead afraid of that bridge over next to the pump station, that people will accommodate themselves. They'll start going through Sunderland, they'll start going through South Hadley in order to get to the university, just like they did when the bridge was packed up out here. So I think that they said to us that we know there'll be, we know it's going to be an inconvenience. It's a project. As Mr. Michkowski said earlier, traffic is traffic. We can only do so much with it. And we've had the conversations with them, and I think that they've done a lot of things to try to get ahead of the curve, and we're just going to see how this works itself out.
I think if we give them a heads up, and if there's going to be a problem at certain times, that it's up to them to provide coverage and hire police officers to alleviate some of the problems.
Yeah, that's the concern, just as long as they're open to the fact that...
It's their project, so they would have to own...
We don't have to push and try to... Because when we had the issue... The work down there in front of Lowe's, that was a nightmare. We couldn't get them to do anything above and beyond what the contract said.
It's the state. What do you want?
Well, I would hope that they would.
You know, what are you gonna do?
I'm excited to get the water.
Don, you had a question first, and then Andy?
Just a point of clarification. For the last year, I've been going on 91 back and forth twice a day. This is the same company that's coming here to do this intersection. They're the same company that replaced the four bridges over the Deerfield River, and minimal impact on 91, with all the traffic was there. They're a very reputable construction company. I guess you can just look at Russell School, ride by it, and look at the grounds, what they've done around there after the way it was left. It's almost impeccable. They've seeded everything, graded everything. It really looks good.
You know the town of Hadley did that, right, Donald? Marlo's guys did that.
You guys did that?
Yeah, we cleaned up.
Where was the roller from? I thought that was from somebody else, the big roller.
I think that was Colcott's roller, and they rolled a school with it.
Yeah. But we did the after-winter cleanup there.
Well, I come in the highway department, and I'm sorry. I thought it was the construction company that come in. No. You guys did a great job.
We want to make our new tenants feel good when they get
a Again, that's the state. We're not doing nothing.
Yeah, you know, we got a crew down there that knows what they're doing once in a while.
Andy, did you have a comment?
Yeah, two, real quick. When they first did the bridge down by Bay Road, they I've been through there enough to see their signage, and it was apparent that after the first few weeks, the signage was not adequate, and they came through and increased the signage. I'd like to see them do a little bit better job up front this time around. And many of us recall that when they did work on Route 9 in the past, they diverted a lot of traffic down onto Bay Road and then up East Street. Mm-hmm. And with the bridge construction alone, it's a nightmare getting down around that corner. The bottom of East Street is a tight spot to begin with. We know with Chief was here, I'm sure the number of accidents down there is relatively high for a spot off of Route 9. There's gonna need to be extra detail, particularly during rush hour, because that's a stop sign down there, and now you've got a bridge with a light on it, and it's just gonna be a mess. And that's just major thoroughfare, because that's the Belchertown Turnpike, and you know, in the South Hadley run, and for those of us that live,
state addressed all of that with the police service and everything else.
Yes. I hope if you're talking about getting ahead of something, to me that's going to be a hot spot. You know, granted, it's a little self-serving, but it's just still going to be a hot spot there anyway. Because if they divert traffic down that way, they're either going to do it up north or south. Either way, there's going to be an intersection.
They could reroute up from Route 9 down the Bay Road out to the lights.
Yep.
You know, contribute some of the traffic to go one way, another way.
Yeah, it's just good. That whole corner's going to be bad.
So one of the things that we made sure happened at the pre-construction conference is we invited the University of Massachusetts to be there so that they could talk about the kinds of traffic impacts that they could foresee based upon some of their major events, such as graduation, coming back into the school, some of the other kinds of events that might be there. So it was nice in football season. It was nice to have UMass there in the room so that they could talk about their needs and kind of being mindful of their impacts. And so everybody has a sense that we're all going to work as collaboratively as possible to minimize the disruptions that are inevitably going to happen from a project of this type.
Any increased bus service at all by any chance?
I can talk to them about that. Yeah.
Bus service? Well, they actually cut down on their bus service once school is. They changed their.
Yeah. Plus, they have those events there that sometimes draw 10,000 people in on a weekend day.
Yeah. Every Sunday, Jehovah's Witness.
Yep.
So they can start advising their people alternate routes rather than coming down Route 9. So everybody's trying to work together on this one. It's going to be painful for folks, but if we're going to get through it, we're going to have a better infrastructure because of it. There are a couple of other things I want to touch on, but I want to make sure that you've had it.
Can you speak louder? I can't hear you.
Sure. Are you, anything else?
I just wanted to also say it is going to be a construction zone. I mean, I didn't want to paint a perfect picture of a perfect new highway out there while they're working on it, but they did assure me that there's no work going on the weekends and everything will be left open full lanes as much as possible for weekends, all weekends. So I think that's probably most important. I know, I mean, it's busy out here every day of the week, but with these functions going on in different areas with the weekends, especially the weekend traffic in and out, I think.
And there will be a decrease in traffic once graduation takes place at the colleges. We all know that. It does decrease some, you know, until some of these other things start up for the summertime, but hopefully it won't be as bad after graduation, but.
And things, you know, things can happen. They can find things where they didn't expect them. They can't find things where they expect them.
Mm-hmm.
If there's any changes, I will make sure that I run that immediately up through the chain, through the administrator and the select board if we got.
And you have your Lacy on, Jerry, that
yes.
He can always keep us abreast of things.
Lacy on? Did you say Lacy on?
Liaison.
Liaison?
Liaison.
I think you did that on purpose.
That's right.
Okay.
This is a guy you keep in touch with.
I got one more question. I've already asked you. Boston.
Okay.
Jerry did a great job on the town hall last time you were on the board. But we've got a drinking fountain out there that we should have activated while we're going through all the water, and it's only a couple feet away.
Okay.
That we maybe should address.
Should have done that with the town common one too.
That was my second point.
They were right out here.
They were both active for 200 years, and all of a sudden they got disconnected and not reconnected.
Maybe with new pipes there won't be lead in them.
There's probably no backflow preventers on them either.
I think the chlorine ruined the line.
You think?
That's what I would hear.
The point I'm trying to make is the water is actually getting better in town now. We've actually got some compliments. So maybe we can get some drinking fountains in front of town hall and back on a common, and people can test our water and get our name back that we do have good water in town.
Marla, you got almost everything fixed.
Oh, I got a long ways.
I was talking to John Kukowski. He's got loads of sand in his system in all the houses on Cummins Road. There's something going on there.
I think they're in the process of flushing right now, aren't they?
Cummins Road?
Yes.
David?
Okay, so there are a couple of technical things we need to address having to do with Route 9. The first is that, if you remember, we initially applied for the SRF loan back last August. We were denied, and then Senator Rosenberg was good enough to get us back into the SRF pool, and we're going to have this funded at under the SRF program. But it meant that we're doing everything procedurally backwards. Things that should have happened back in September we're now getting to. So one of the things we're doing is we're working with bond counsel about getting the appropriate certifications to move forward with this project under the SRF program, something I would have normally have brought to you last September, except we were rejected under the program and I thought we were out of the game. So in front of you is two copies of a certification. If you could take a vote to authorize the chair to sign, that would be very helpful, and we'll get that over to bond counsel. This is the top two things, their choice.
This one?
No, keep going.
These two.
No, keep going. Keep going. There you go.
It's like that alligator that can't reach for the
I
bill.
I know. I always pay my bill. Okay.
Make a motion that the chair ratify documents.
Second motion.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, thank you. The second thing has to do with change orders for the project.
Hasn't started yet.
I understand. this is something that the...
I just changed it. We got to get the water
phone. Only in Hadley.
This is something that the board talked about a few months ago, that as we gear up for this project, that the board wanted to make sure that we had cost containment on this project, and so there is a letter to MassDOT and to the contractor specifying that change orders are authorized by written consent of the select board only. Under an emergency situation, Mr. Warner would exercise the powers of the select board for the emergency.
Please be advised that no change orders affecting the town of Hadley scope of work are authorized except through explicit written agreement of the Board of Selectmen. So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
To answer your question on the water fountain, I'm not sure if I, it's certainly something we can look into. And we also, we do have that main off road out here if it's something we can't get accomplished during the construction phase.
Yeah, we moved it back once already, so.
One last question before we end this. Where are they going to keep all their excess equipment when they're not using it? It's not going to be at the Russell School site, I don't think, right?
No.
Where are they putting it?
The back lot at the American Legion is where they're going to be staging. Gary Berg had set that all up previous, or we're starting to set it up before I came aboard. They're going to stage it in a way, they're well aware of the parade and other activities, so we're going to work with them, they're going to work with us to make sure it's staged. To my understanding, the parade comes through there to start.
That's where it all starts.
The first parade's going to have a roller in it.
So then that site should be up to negotiation with the rental price too?
Yes.
Okay, it's inclusive?
It'll be something we'll talk about on Wednesday.
Okay, good. I just wanted to be sure.
Quick park and rec point is that they use that field in the fall for soccer games. So if we're farther down the road in staging, there's a lot of equipment back there. It might be helpful to put up some kind of temporary barrier.
There's a barrier that's going up. He's putting up jersey barriers.
Yeah.
On the west side and east side with a gate. And full height gates on the south and north side. And most of it's in the parking lot. And very minimal amount of actual areas going to, you're only talking a few feet of where the jersey barriers are, in the grassed area. So it's all in.
How's that going to affect American Legion parking if they have a large effect?
Well, it is our property.
I realize that.
There's not that many people that go up there. Yes, it's going to affect it on their large times. But if he has also said that if he has information that he can move some of that over here, he said he'll accommodate as much as he can. Like the parade, he's going to get it all out of there and open it up so we can stage within that area too.
The other thing, if there's a larger event there on the weekends or something, and they need to move something, it's not far to the yard. They need to park equipment down the yard just over the weekend, the DPW yard. We can work with that also if there's a large event at the American Legion.
Okay, so Lake Warner Dam repair has been, that's not on the agenda tonight. And Council on Aging appointment, be Jane.
No, me.
Do you want to talk to your appointment of Rose Lee?
I'm not on that board, but I know that the council wants to have her appointment approved.
I'm sorry.
Rosalie Weinberg has the offer to serve on the Council on Aging, and the Council on Aging is pleased to have her join. So if we could have a motion to accept.
On their recommendation, I'd like to appoint Rosalie Weinberg to the Council on Aging.
I'll second that motion.
All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Thank you, Rosalie, for offering.
Are there any other openings on that board that we know of?
Not yet.
Okay, good.
And
so concludes.
I think so concludes our meeting. Did the building committee have anything to offer?
I actually would like to. John, you're the liaison to the building committee? Do you have time to attend their meetings? Because if you don't, I mean, Mr. Denlenko had a chance to speak to me this morning regarding that he thought it would be helpful if we were able to get to some of the meetings. And I know how busy you are and not being able to get to. So if it was okay with you, I'd like to offer to be the liaison to the buildings committee as well. I know I'd be able to make a lot of the appointments and hopefully increase and do a better job of communicating between our two boards, if that's acceptable to you.
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, I'm keeping a little bit abreast with Mr. Kopacki and Gary Berg on the board. But, yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
Appreciate it.
Chairman?
Yeah, any and all
we would invite you to.
Any and all, come along.
More communication, the better.
And your next meeting is?
We're
next Tuesday.
This next Tuesday. We are the first and third Tuesdays of the month.
First and third Tuesdays of the month. Yes.
Could I get an update on the infrastructure? I just don't seem to get an answer from you folks. So what steps are you doing? Sewer, water, and drainage.
That'll be coming up at one of our future agendas.
I think Marlo's been here for a grand total of 7 weeks and is aware of your concerns and the concerns of the community. And I think he's done a lot of good things in the first 7 weeks, but he obviously hasn't gotten to everything. So this is one of the things that's on his radar. He's certainly going to be bringing that forward to us, and it's scheduled to be sometime during the summer to address that issue.
What does it take for a petition to do this for the fall town meeting?
Signatures, John, or of the board. The board can either do that or 100 signatures.
It's covered by Mass General Law.
Yeah, petition by 100 signatures.
How much?
100.
That's easy enough.
Yeah. Okay.
I have one question for Tim. Mm-hmm. You do the counting of cars on property?
I can, if I'm asked.
On the corner of East Street, and I received several complaints. Mm-hmm. About his vehicles being in the way of not being able to see when they're coming out of E Street.
Especially with now that you put those U-Hauls. I talked to Bill Dwyer, yes. I need to get over there on that.
Yes,
I will be
the large vans are obstructing the view, especially
exactly.
When a police or fire apparatus is coming. They don't have time to move because they don't know what's coming on the other side. So if he could repark those vehicles, that would certainly help.
Yeah, it's that and the pedestrians. You got the sidewalk right there.
You got a sidewalk.
The cars
right
weren't bad. First two parking places or three parking places when there was a low car there, but now he's got those two U-Haul vans.
There's
a pretty tough.
He doesn't have authorization to have U-Haul.
No.
So I will be addressing that.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. One last thing I'd like to bring up. When I ran for election, I made a comment at one of the meetings that I would like, if I won or lost, to do an Earth Day cleanup day in Hadley. And I would like the board's blessing. I did it 25 years ago, and it was wonderful. We cleaned all the roads with volunteer people in town. I would like to get the board's blessing on this. I would have a date of May 7th. We'd probably start at 9:00 in the morning and be done at 12. We also are gonna check into the gateways into town, getting help from the sheriff's department to do those, but we'll have a staging area where we have coffee and donuts to get started and assign streets for cleaning. The people that volunteer would probably like to do their own areas. And then at noon, we would have a light lunch for the people when they finished up. So all I would like is the blessing of the board to go ahead and do this.
Fantastic idea, sure. Certainly.
Great.
Joyce, you got that day off?
I don't. Oh.
Just a point of reference, Earth Day was April 22nd.
You know,
Earth Day was April 22nd.
Earth Day was April 22nd.
So you may want to rename the.
Want to rename it. Earth Day was April 22nd.
Yeah, we missed it.
We did.
Yeah, I know that. I was in Aruba then. I thought about it, but I couldn't be here.
That's a nice place on Earth.
We'll call it Hadley Day. How's that?
As a cleanup day.
Yeah. Nice day on
Earth Day. Just like they used to do for Little League and Lassie League.
Okay, our administrator said we should have a formal motion on this.
I make a motion that we support Donald's idea of, and it's, you're going to rename it?
Hadley Cleanup Day.
I'll second that. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Alrighty. And announcements. I have it here. The American Legion. We have the Memorial Day Parade on Sunday, May 29th. No rain date, so get your umbrellas out. Hopefully you won't need them. It'll be a great day. We start with the meeting at the American Legion at 10:45. I would like all my selectmen to be available again to march in the parade this year, if they could possibly do that.
Yes, ma'am.
I'd be most honored if you'd join me. I haven't missed one.
Your select board?
Hey, she's in the big chair tonight, Johnny. She's in the big chair tonight.
I think 509 votes. Hey, did you rig that?
I did.
Give it to her, John.
Since I am the most senior person on the board, I guess I can call it my select board.
Careful when you use that one, too.
And I actually marched every year for 15 years when I was on school committee.
You were riding.
So, I was not riding. I did not ride. I rode 1 year when I had my hip replaced.
Oh, that was a donkey you were riding on.
No, I think that was with Stewie Russell in his Jeep.
Right.
What time's the parade start?
Parade starts itself at 2 p.m. at the Legion with the raising of the flag. So we do the cemeteries first, and then they do the parade down Route 9 to the West Street Common, and then everybody is invited back to the Legion for
food steak.
Yeah, hot dogs. And if you would like to be in the parade, you can contact John Karras, Tommy Stolarski, Kathy Zaturka, or Gene Baxter, who have worked at this for many years themselves also.
Before you wrap this meeting up.
Three more things.
Is it?
I got three of them.
I'm talking to her.
Go ahead, I'm not done, but okay. Go ahead.
I would like, before you make a decision on North Hadley Hall, to present an alternative for that land there, for the town. Can I get on the agenda for your next meeting?
It won't be next Wednesday. Probably the first meeting of June.
No. When are you going to deal with the land?
Well, we're not sure. We're going to talk about it next week.
Well, can I get on the agenda to make a presentation? Probably take 5 minutes.
That's my promise.
Well, I haven't ever seen anything you do in 5 minutes, but
well, you asked a lot of questions.
Let's see.
Oh boy, that's a softball.
So we will go over that with Molly at that point. The problem I have with it is that we've already had many discussions on this, that the RFP had gone out, that the town voters had voted to sell the building and the land in North Hadley. We've been doing that. It was a two-year-old vote. The building committee has worked diligently to get this building set up.
Don't give up. You didn't look for other alternatives. That's what you need to do. It's going to like what happened to the elementary.
I think the board has done a really good job with what they're doing.
Well,
so I think, you know, I hate this late date business that happens all the time. You know,
it doesn't make any difference.
It does make a difference. Nothing gets moved forward in this town. Nothing gets moved forward. We stay stale. We don't get anything done. And then people like you come back at us and say,
"Wait,
why haven't
people?" What do you mean, people like me?
That come back and say that things don't get done.
What about people like you?
Oh, I'm very proud of me.
I'm asking just to make a presentation.
Well, I guess
you can throw it in a dump, but at least I want to see the people see an alternative solution to that site.
I think it'll be taken under consideration.
The committee is going to make recommendations to the Board of Selectmen, right?
Correct.
And then the Board of Selectmen will make the final decision.
Correct.
Okay.
Well, what's wrong with an alternative plan?
Well, I think it isn't that there's already a committee set up to review the RFPs.
Well,
so you can contact.
If you sell the land, there will have to be a 10 taxpayer injunction against it to stop you. That's all. And if it needs to be done that.
Are you threatening to do something again?
No, I'm just saying it. I'm not threatening. I'm just saying, how else would this get on?
Yeah, it's close to getting through this meeting.
Okay. We're almost done.
Can you make your presentation to the recommendation committee?
Recommendation has all been made.
It's all done.
Molly will set the agenda for the next meeting. That's first to set.
I gave him that plan. I don't know. When did I bring that plan up there? 2 weeks ago?
Everything's already on a warrant, and it's already in front of
the board. That's not for this town.
No, this is North Hadley Hall, buying and selling the land.
But the RFP is already in front of the board.
So what?
It's going through the committee right now.
Yeah.
And the committee is reviewing it now for their recommendation to come to the board. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
we reviewed the board proposals.
And when is the committee?
It's already here.
We've already reviewed that part of the committee has already reviewed those two proposals. We're done with that.
Okay, I didn't see that. Something I missed last week being away.
Right.
Okay, I understand where you're coming from now.
That one is already done with the two proposals.
Okay, and the recommendations are coming to the board, and we'll make the decision next week.
Next week.
Very good.
So David.
So Mr. Michikowski has made a request to be on next week's agenda. The chair sets the agenda. I will email his request to the chair. She'll make a decision.
Okay.
I think that's all we can say tonight.
So that's up to the chair?
The chair sets the agenda.
We'll see what happens.
Okay. And I have one more announcement.
After you, ma'am.
And then you, sir. The select board would like to extend their condolences to the family of Nathan Kaminsky. We hope he is at peace at this time, and thoughts and prayers to their family.
Another reminder about the fishing derby coming up on the 30th. That's this Saturday. I know that the DPW has gone up there and done some clearing around the pond up there so the kids can have a great time fishing up there. That's open to everybody. A lot of gifts and things like that. The Mothers Club would like to thank everybody involved with Recycling Day, most especially John Washkevitz, whose time and effort has always been extremely helpful in making that a very successful day. So John, thanks a million from the Mothers Club publicly, and appreciate that. And I'd like to tell everybody I had asparagus for supper tonight. Everybody, they're picking asparagus. Get out, right. Save your money, and go buy some Hadley asparagus.
Was it Hadley asparagus?
Hadley asparagus, California? From very close to your heart up there in North Hadley.
Yeah, I know where you got it. You're weak.
Motion to adjourn.
Weak weight. All those in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.